Hey guys, what's up? Jeremy Schaefer here. So, as promised, in this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to make the rest of this gauntlet or dragon armor. If you haven't made the dragon claws or gauntlet fingers, I have a separate video for that. Click here. So first I'm going to show you how to make the hand armor, and then I'll show you how to make the wrist armor. Each of these is folded from a 10-inch square, and for these I used brown commie, and I painted over the top with copper acrylic paint. But for this tutorial, I'm going to show you from a couple sheets of 10-inch beige commie that I painted on top with golden acrylic paint. So let's get to it. Let's start out with the hand armor. So I think I better disarm. Okay, so let's begin white side up and let's fold diagonally in half. And let's rotate, and let's fold again in half. All right, now let's unfold and rotate, and let's fold this corner up to the midpoint. And unfold and rotate. And now let's fold this edge to the crease. And unfold and rotate and fold this flap up to this point, this intersection of creases. And now let's unfold and now let's fold this flap up to this last crease, like that, and unfold, and let's fold it up to the first crease, right at this intersection point. And let's leave it folded, and let's rotate, and now let's fold the bottom edge to this crease. And unfold, and now let's fold the bottom edge to this point, right to the corner that we folded before. Okay, and now let's unfold the two flaps, well, three flaps. All right, now let's turn over left to right, and let's fold not the first crease, not the second, but the third crease. What we're going to do is lift it up, both layers, and we're going to just fold it up just a tiny bit. I'm going to show you up close how much I folded it up. It's not that important, but about like that. And we're going to do that on the next three creases. So this one, and here, and here. Okay, now let's make these pleats really sharp. Okay, now let's turn over right to left and let's rotate and let's fold this corner to the midpoint right there. And let's do the same thing with this corner. And now let's fold this in half again and unfold. And now we're going to slip one flap inside the other. So slide it in. How far? We want to slide it in so that the second creases touch right there. Oh, actually, we can slide it all the way to here. Okay, now let's turn over and let's fold this whole edge inside of here. So let's start right here. Make sure that you're holding here so that they don't slide apart. They should be slid together like this. Okay, holding it like this, fold this edge inside, and let's go around the triangle, folding the edge inside. So it's like that. And we're going to fold this edge in one more time. So starting right here again, let's fold this edge inside and let's go around the triangle like we did before. Okay, so this is what it should look like. And you can try to make it as sharp as you can. Oh, you want to make sure that this edge right here goes on top of the pleat all around it. So make sure that the pleat goes underneath like that. And yeah, this is already underneath. Okay. All right, now let's flatten it. So we're going to fold right along the existing fold and make a fold right here. And open it up and let's bring these two points together. So we're going to squash it down. So these two come together and let's make two new folds. Okay, and let's open it, and you should have a square. So what we're gonna do now is let's squash the square so that these two points come together and these two come together. So it's like that. And let's continue this fold all the way down. And let's flatten and make the new fold right here. And fix it up, make sure that none of the pleats get unfolded like that. And flatten it. Okay, let's open it again. And now we're going to bring these two points together so that they touch. And let's flatten it again. And let's open it up again. All right, now you should have an octagon. It might not be a very good octagon, but it should have eight sides. And now we're going to squeeze all of the mountain folds together. So let's start anywhere and just bring the two folds together like this. And let's bring these two together. And just continue all the way around. Okay, and just squeeze them all together so that we have an 8-pointed star. And here is the hand armor. And you can just stick it on your hand. It just slides onto your hand like this. And you want to align 4 of the ridges with your fingers. So it's like that. So when you put on the claw armor parts, then these points should line up with the ridges. Okay. So we got the hand armor done. Now let's do the wrist armor. So I'm going to use another square of gold painted kami. And let's begin white side up. And let's fold in half diagonally again. And rotate and fold in half again. And let's unfold and rotate. And now let's fold this corner to this point, but we're just gonna make a little crease mark. So it's right there. Pinch that and unfold and rotate. And now let's fold the bottom edge to the crease mark. So make sure that this point aligns with the crease mark. And try to get it as even as possible. And make the fold. Okay, now let's unfold and rotate. And now let's fold these flaps up to this point. And unfold both flaps. And now let's fold the flap up so that this crease aligns with this crease. Okay, and unfold. And now let's fold this corner up to this intersection point. Okay, now let's unfold and let's turn over top to bottom and let's lift up not the first crease, but the second crease. And we're going to fold it onto that little crease mark that we made. So lift it up and flatten it onto the crease mark. So it's like that. You see, we made a little pleat. Okay, let's make the same sized pleat on the other creases. It doesn't need to be exact, but just to give you an idea, it should be about the same. Okay, and now let's make all of these pleats very sharp. Okay, now let's turn over right to left and let's fold this corner to the midpoint. And let's do the same thing on this side. And let's fold it in half again. And unfold and lift these flaps up. And now let's stick one inside the other. So just slide it in as far in as it goes. So it's like that. And now let's flatten it. Like that. Okay, now let's open it and let's bring these two points together. So we're just flattening it and these two points touch and then flatten the rest of it. All right, make sure that these flaps stay together so that these two points are touching. All right, now let's turn over and let's fold this edge to this crease, but we're actually just gonna make a little crease mark right there and unfold. And now let's fold this bottom edge to the crease mark. And this time, let's fold all the way across. Okay, now let's open this flap. Just bring this down. And let's squash on the right and the left. Oops, I didn't do very good here. I'm gonna just fix that up. Okay, that's better. All right, now let's open this pocket right here and let's turn it over. And now we're going to make this middle fold and let's bring it over to here. So I better zoom out a little bit. So we're bringing this fold to this fold, and we're making a new fold in between. And unfold it. And now let's bring this edge over to this edge, and let's make a new fold in between right here. Okay, and now let's flatten it, incorporating the new folds that we just made. So it's like this. Okay, now let's rotate. And let's fold this flap up like this. And now let's open this slot and let's squash right here. So it's like that, and let's fold this flap down like that. So basically what we did is we just made a reverse fold on this corner like that. Okay, now let's open it up again and open here, and let's fold this flap up like that. And let's do the same thing in this slot. So open the flaps and let's fold this flap up like this. All right, now let's make a fold on this flap. We're going to fold right between this point and this point. This is optional, it'll just give a little bit more shape to the gauntlet. Okay, and unfold. And let's do the same thing on this side. So we're folding between this point and this point. Okay, and unfold. And now we are done with the wrist armor, and now we just need to put it on. So this is how to do it. Stick your hand in from behind, and oops, we can't get it in. But this is how you do it. You just have to undo this flap and unfold this flap. And now you should be able to slide your hand into it. Like that. I have a big hand and I can still slide it in. So now we just need to relock it. So remake the folds as they were. Let's take this flap and fold it over. And let's fold this flap over. Make sure that this one stays down. So it's like that. And now it fits nice and snugly on your hand. And now you can just shape it to taste. You can remake this fold. And this should go on top of the wrist, so it creates that kind of shape to it. And you can just shape it to taste however you want. You can pull here and fold it over if you want. That can be like a dragon point if you reach in here and just kind of squash it like that. However you want, just shape it to taste. And there you have it. All right, now I'm going to show you how to attach the hand part. But before we do that, I have to show you how to take this off. So let's undo these latches and pull your hand out and redo the latches. Okay, now I'm going to show you how to attach the hand part. So what you want to do is let's first turn over and let's fold this corner up to the nearest crease. There is a crease there. You can hardly see it, but it's there. And let's turn back over. You can see it on this side really clearly. Now what we want to do is let's fold this flap behind on the crease and unfold it. And now what we want to do is stick this flap into this slot right here. So open the flap and just slide the flap into the pocket. So it's like that. And pinch. Now, this would come out really easily, right? But there's a way to actually keep it in a lot better, and it requires looking inside the model. So let's turn it over like this. And what we're going to do is we're going to fold this edge up. So we're folding it however much you want, but I think you should fold it up about half of this width right here. And just kind of taper it off like that. And like that, so we can still stick the hand inside. And now it's well locked. And it's time to put it back on. So let's undo the latches and stick your hand inside so it goes into the glove. And now let's redo the latches. And once again, shape it to taste. And now you want to put on the claws. I'm going to just put on the same copper claws. And there it is. All right, that was a pretty epic tutorial. And now you gotta try to do it on the other side. But they're symmetrical, so it's basically the same thing. So hope you guys have the patience to complete this model. I know it's pretty ridiculous how many pieces of paper this requires, but I think it's pretty cool, and I think it'll make a nice costume for Halloween or any other time you want to dress up like a dragon or an armored person. So, all right, hope you guys like that, and I'll catch you later. Bye-bye.